This is the summer headquarters of the Texas A&M University Commerce Trumpet Studio. I have a few thoughts to share with you about the Duem A-flat major etude, and then I'll demonstrate for you. A couple of things to keep in mind about this etude first. This is a great etude to show off your cantabile or vocal singing style, and if you have vibrato in your toolkit, now's the time to use it. Also, be aware of places where the phrases end down or up a half step or a whole step. For example, the second measure, beat 3, also when that returns in measure 18, and a couple of other spots. Make sure that we're not pouncing on the last note of the phrase. The stress is in the half note here, and then it resolves on the eighth note or the quarter note that comes after it. So think more D, and not D, I'm done. Keep your articulation very, very fluid and vocal, even in the fast rhythms. Always avoid the tut. Try to keep your air flowing through your articulation rather than stopping and starting again. Be sure to observe the rallentandos and retardandos in the piece. Pull your tempo back and relax your approach here. And be sure to continue that slow tempo through measure 24 at the end of the excerpt. There's no reason to rush through the half note just because you're finished. And finally, dynamics are really, really important and they're easy to judge. Notice in measure 7 that we've climbed up to a forte. Make sure that you stay loud throughout that measure, even though we're going back down in your register. Stay robust all the way to the low C. In the Baim a la Breve etude, this is all about risoluto, a strong, robust articulation and great trumpet sound. It's very easy to slip into a tut-tut-tut articulation when you're moving this fast and this loud. Your goal is to keep your articulation rounded and polite, even though you're playing high and loud at times. Note centering is very important here as well. It's very easy to allow some notes to be a little high or a little low as you're going up or down an arpeggio or a scale. Listen very carefully to what your trumpet is telling you as far as tone and intonation. Work with a metronome very diligently and slow at first. It's very easy to miscount ties or to slow down as you get to a more difficult passage. Be sure to put a little extra emphasis on the notes that are accented, whether they're high or low. And check your note placement in the beginning of line 6. It's very easy to overshoot or undershoot G's and C's as you're flying up to those upper G's.